Mass Effect Andromeda is the latest entry in BioWare's epic sci-fi RPG series. Joe Juba has been reviewing it.
Yes.
And he's going to tell me four things about it.
Shuttle 2, taking your lead.
Good luck, Pathfinder team.
So Mass Effect Andromeda is a new start for the Mass Effect series in a lot of ways. So some people maybe were a little worried that it's not going to feel like Mass Effect with a lot of the changes they're making. The thing that probably surprised me the most about the game is that it does feel so much like Mass Effect. Despite having a new lead character, a new galaxy, all these new things to explore, it still holds on to all of the things that have defined Mass Effect over the years. Mass Effect Andromeda does have a sort of critical path storyline that you work through, but you will not run out of things to do quickly if you really want to dig into it. There's a ton of side content in this game, ranging from, like we've seen before, loyalty missions for squadmate. There's a sort of mystery about your main character's family connections. Then, of course, there's just a lot of exploration-based side quests you can do, from, you know, going and finding satellites and placing settlements, making planets more habitable. Every world you visit is this sort of landscape that you can go and gradually unlock and explore. But if you don't want to get too deep into that, you can also focus in on the story and see that through to the end.
Leaders think our search for Meridian is a waste of time, but we know they're wrong.
The combat system in Mass Effect Andromeda is the best that it's ever been in this series. It feels a lot like the multiplayer from Mass Effect 3, tuned to be even more responsive, but there's a focus on agility, a focus on combining your powers. The environments have more dimensions, so you're not just cowering behind various pieces of cover in an arena. There are different levels to it that you might use your jetpack to jump between and things like that. It makes the encounters feel more dynamic, and it makes you feel like you have greater control over the battlefield. If you want to dig into Mass Effect Andromeda, one of the things you need to be aware of is that you're going to run into some technical issues, beyond even probably some of those funny animations and things that, you know, you may have seen online. I ran into several during my playthrough of things that would sort of like stop quest progress, of things that would, you know, require me to just like reload the game, and other various bugs and glitches, from characters facing the wrong directions to them not having a body. These aren't individually huge problems, but when taken as a whole, they lend the experience a sort of unpolished or rushed feeling that's just a little disappointing.
Okay, so you're telling me you don't actually play as a disembodied head for the majority of this game?
Correct.
Pathfinder. Sorry, distracted.
So that's Mass Effect Andromeda. Comes out PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC on March 21st. Joe Juba, our review is online right now.
It is, and you can check that out to hear more about these points and other ones that we didn't cover in the video.
And we also had Mass Effect Andromeda on our cover, and we have all kinds of features from going to the studio and talking to BioWare. Even a fun, silly video of you asking the director a lot of questions.
That was a lot of fun.
Thanks for watching, and make sure you go to GameInformer.com and click on stuff.